Hey guys, welcome to our channel. So today we are going to show you something fun. What are we going to do, Babu?
Play-Doh!
Yes, we will be showing you how to make Play-Doh at home using all the natural ingredients. So Iksha loves Play-Doh and I'm sure most kids do. It has got a lot of amazing benefits, like it's a good exercise for their hand muscles. Besides, you can also do a lot of creative activities. However, the store-bought Play-Dohs are not safe for young children because it contains artificial colors and chemicals, and kids usually tend to put it to their mouth. Also, I've noticed that, you know, while Iksha plays with it, it gets stuck in between her nails, which is not safe. So I thought of giving it a try at home and it came out really well. Since then, we have been doing it using all the natural colors. I would suggest you to involve your child in this process because they are going to enjoy it thoroughly. So today, I'll be showing you how to make Play-Doh at home.
For this you will need 2 cups all-purpose flour, 3/4 to 1 cup refined salt, 1 teaspoon oil, you can use any oil of your choice, I've used olive oil, then homemade natural colors and warm water. Here we are using these measuring cups. So what I suggest is, if you're doing it for the first time, then do not do it in large quantities. Instead of using 2 cups flour, you can just go with 1 cup, and for that you can use 1/4 cup of refined salt. Iksha likes coarse texture, that's why I'm using 1 cup refined salt here. Otherwise, even half a cup is good to go. You can modify the quantities based on your child's interest. Mix the salt and flour mixture really well. You can also store this in airtight container for a very long time and use it whenever required. So first, I will be showing you the white dough without adding any color. For this, you will need 2 tablespoons of the mixture, warm water sufficient enough to make the dough, as well as oil. Using warm water is really important, so please do not use cold water. Also, this mixture of warm water and oil gives a smooth texture to your dough. Salt is the hero here. It acts as a preservative and also gives a nice texture to your dough. So if you're planning to store your dough for about a month in the fridge and use it later on, you won't get that foul smell and sogginess because you have added salt. So our white dough is ready here. It's soft and it's non-sticky. So this is the consistency you should aim for. Our next color is yellow. For this we are using 1 to 2 tablespoons of turmeric powder. Take some water in your saucepan, add turmeric powder and boil well. Once you have strained it, this is how it should look. Then follow the same method. In a bowl we have taken 2 tablespoons of the flour mixture, and to the turmeric water I am adding 1 teaspoon oil. Then slowly add this mixture to the flour and make the dough. If you want light reddish to pink color, then you can use strawberries along with grated beetroots. I did not have beetroot, that's why I'm just using 2 to 3 chopped strawberries here. Clean the strawberries really well, chop it and boil it with some water, strain it and repeat the process. So this is how it looks. You can use grated beetroot instead of strawberries, or you can use both to get a darker shade. For green color, I'm using few chopped spinach leaves here. You can use any green leafy vegetable to get the desired color. I recommend you to use small quantities of fruits and veggies. Also, select the ones that you plan to discard. Instead of throwing it away, you can use it in your Play-Doh. For brown color, I used 1 teaspoon tea powder and 1 teaspoon coffee powder. For purple color, I use some blueberries, boil it with some water, strain it and follow the same process. Using food color is an alternative method for older kids. The process, however, remains the same. In a bowl, take 1 to 2 tablespoons of the flour mixture. To this, you add warm water mixed with olive oil and then 2 to 3 drops of food color. If you have small kids who put everything to their mouth, then I suggest you to go for natural colors. Once your dough is ready, you can store it in the fridge using Ziploc bags or airtight containers for up to a month. Also, at any point when your kid is playing with it, if you feel that you know it's too sticky, then just add some extra flour salt mixture and you're good to go. I hope this video was helpful. Please let me know through your messages and do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. Take care guys. Bye-bye.